if it really needed, if we really need to fight on the battlefield?
To be honest, if I have the choice, then I don't want to serve in the military.
But I think not just about the place. Whether you can pursue your dreams freely depends more on the people and the time.
I feel like my passions and interests are not held at a really high regard here in Taiwan.
I don't think my family can support me go to medicine school in other countries. So I will just have to like choose between being a doctor or move out.
You're tuning in to YouthSpeak, an unscripted show that delves into the thoughts of the youth in Taiwan. Each episode focuses on a particular topic and brings together some young individuals from various parts of Taiwan to share their perspectives. We've carefully selected questions related to the topic, and through these discussions, you hear their thoughts, struggles, and hopes. My life will be better than my parents. Agreeers, please step forward.
For me, I think my life will be better than my parents because of the education.
I think my life will be better than my parents because the whole world is improving.
I think my life will be better than my parents because the technology has advanced so much.
Now, disagreeers, please come forward.
I don't think that my life will be better. For one simple reason, the earth is dying.
I don't think my life will be better than my parents because they both work in the science field.
I don't think my life will be better because the natural environment is getting worse and the price of the houses is surging.
If you don't think your life will be better than your parents, what's the point of all this?
Just because I don't think my life will be better doesn't mean I don't have to live.
Yeah,
I agree.
Well, an organism avoids itself from dying.
True.
I'm just basically breathing. I'm a walking corpse.
So isn't this kind of living is not better than your parent? How do you define this better than your parent?
I think better means a sense of well-being. So right now, I don't think I'm happier than my parents.
So no, so you're not happy now?
I am. Well, sometimes I am happy, but mostly I'm depressed.
I'm sorry of that.
It's okay. You don't have to feel sorry.
I don't think we need to worry about future too much because just live in present. Yes. Do as much as I can. I think it's the best way to like make us improve. Yes.
That's so optimistic.
Like if you worry about AI will take your job, there's nothing you can do about it. You can maybe adopt it. You can use more AI, become part of them. But, you know, when AI is really going to take your job, what can you do? Just live at the moment and live happier.
If you don't have a job, how can you be happy?
I mean, at the moment, I don't have a job. I'm a student.
Well, in the future, then.
Well,
how are you going to pay your taxes?
Maybe until then, everybody has no job. There's
right,
no taxes.
You don't have a job, so you will not have a tax to pay.
What is your definition of a good life?
I think a good life is a life you like. So if you feel like your worth is existing in this world, then I think you're living a good life.
I think to live a good life is to be happy in everyday life.
Well, you may go first.
Yeah, sure. First, mentally and physically healthy. And second, doing the things I like. And that's it. Live happy.
Yeah, I think a good life is about being happy. And also, one thing that's really important is to be healthy. And being alive is the basic components. However, with the environmental problem like getting worse, deteriorating. How can we even survive? It's like nobody cares about climate change now.
Well, really?
Well, very little people. And also the people that has actual power to change the entire thing is like, they only care about their own benefits.
Do you think climate change is going to affect your life more than AI or inflation?
Well, AI cannot kill me instantly, but a flaw can.
He's throwing a poll up here, so which means he's not.
Yeah, alive. See? There is no planet B.
Yeah, so.
I think a better life or a good life to me is financial stability and mental and physical wellness and being happy, but I don't think I'll be able to exceed my parents in being financially stable. Like, they bought their first car in university while I don't think I'll even be able to pay the rent on time. So regarding this part, I don't think I'll be able to exceed them, but...
I think so.
Like, yeah, with inflation and all that, how are you going to afford everything, right? So, but I think I'm going to be happier because they both work in the science field. They're very work and goal oriented while I'm
You
like,
have their money.
No, I don't like
Hey.
I'm really into literature, and as we all know, it's not exactly a money making business. So, yeah.
For me, a good life it means a happy life. It doesn't matter how much money you made or the high technology you can use or something like that. It's, the most important is that how happy you are. So as long as you are a happy person, then you have a good life.
Do you appreciate what your parents have done for you?
Yes.
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 You can't say no.
Yeah.
I guess they work every day, and we earn nothing. We're just learning. And they have to pay everything we do, basically. And, you know, taking care of another person or another, maybe I have sisters, another three person people, it's not easy.
I think my parents sacrificed a lot to give me, like, the childhood that they never had. So, I appreciate them a lot.
Like, for me, I would like to share a story. It's that my mom got a cancer when she is pregnant, so she passed away when I'm little. So my dad and my aunt, which is my dad's sister, they raised me up for like 17 years. It's quite a long time, and I'm appreciative of them because they are not really have a good salary, but they always gave me what I want and what I asked for, so I'm very appreciative of them.
To me, my dad works really, really hard every day, and his health condition is getting worse recently, so I appreciate him a lot. And he gave me a lot of resources and cultivated me, and because I learned a lot of talent when I was little, I learned like dancing and swimming and singing, and which are very expensive.
And I think my parents gave everything to me, and I can feel that I'm the only person that they cared. So yes, I appreciate it.
I don't have much to say.
Everything.
Well, they fed me.
I guess so.
What really touched me was the experience of like one time when I was in the hospital and I just got out of surgery, and even though it was like 3 a.m, my dad was still up and trying to feed me orange. And I threw up all over the place, but he just used his hand to pick up those like vomit on the floor or clean up the bed sheets and whatever. And that genuinely really, because before that, my dad and I really don't get along very well. So after that, I started to appreciate what he has done for me.
I feel fortunate to be born in Taiwan. Agreeers, please step forward.
I'm fortunate that I'm born in Taiwan. So I'm glad that I was not born in North Korea.
I feel very fortunate to be born in Taiwan. Although this sounds cliche, but I really like the people here.
Well, for me, Taiwan is it's pretty safe.
Now, disagreeers, please come forward.
I don't necessarily feel not fortunate being born in Taiwan. Yes, so, but when it comes to like saying if born in Taiwan is lucky, then I wouldn't say it's like the luckiest thing in the world, because there are some other countries that are far more advanced than Taiwan, such as like the Northern Europe. Although I might not feel like the luckiest person, but I do appreciate being born in Taiwan. Okay.
I will have kids in the future when I'm ready. Agreeers, please step forward.
I believe that I will have kids in the future if I'm ready.
I think if I have enough money and enough time to accompany my kids, to raise my kids, then why not?
Now, disagreeers, please come forward.
No, I don't want to have a baby, even if I'm ready. First of all, it's the financial problems. And second of all, the baby will screw up my life.
I don't want to take care of somebody for that such a long time. And when I take care of him, like 18 years, that's a bad investment. So, no.
I don't want to have kids in the future. Not because I don't like kids. It's because I don't think the environment overall is good for my kids. And I don't want to commit to those promises if I can't guarantee my children a safe environment to grow up.
Actually, I agree this perspective with you. Yes, because I think if next generation will face a lot of problems, such as their competition pressure and our environment is getting worse. Yes, different people has different definition of I'm ready. So
okay, so that means I'll never be ready.
Right.
Got yes. It.
Would you raise your kids in Taiwan?
Being a parent is like, you are burdened with the responsibility to influence someone their whole life, right? So I, like, on the only difference is that I actually want to have that chance.
Taiwan is stable and we can live here safe and sound, then I think I will raise my kids in Taiwan, yes.
I have a question.
Yes.
Aren't you afraid of the pain?
Like the pain where delivering a child,
yes,
a baby. Epidural. We have.
Well, in which aspects?
I feel like for those people who are want kids, the pain is on the bottom of the list of concerns, right? The most.
Well, really, you guys are. No, you guys are great.
I feel like money, financial stability.
Yes, that would be yeah. The biggest problem.
Is the priority.
Yes.
Guys, if you change your mind, would you raise your kids in Taiwan?
No, definitely not. There are other countries that have better potentials for my kids. So, yeah, such as America or even China, possibly. Because, well, frankly speaking, China is a bigger country, and they have so much people working there, and they have so many opportunities for my kids.
Sorry to interrupt, but like the competition in China is like way worse than Taiwan. It's way, way, way worse.
And
so
that
China
is
might not be a good option.
So you have a mode of life that you want your children go through, right? You will
like
them to go through the way you want them to go. Right?
if I were to have kids, then at least I would like them to respect me. And yeah. Of course, I'll listen to their opinions, but as parents, we all, like, we're all a little bit condescending because we've lived so much longer than your kids. So you will think that you're more experienced and you will be so prejudiced and you will try to change your kids and avoid him or her going through the same mistake that you've made in the past.
This is exactly why I don't want to have a children. Have a child. Yeah, because I think I will be kind of this kind of person.
For me, it depends. Like, if I have much money to send my kids to abroad, okay, I think I'll do it.
To currently, like, in the future, I want to raise my kids. If Taiwan is stable, I still want to raise my kids in Taiwan, yes.
Are you concerned about future competition?
Well, you don't worry about it now, but once you have those pressure, like such as paying your bills, you will worry.
I'm relatively worried about the future competition because, like, I'm quite passionate about literature, and after the introduction of ChatGPT and other writing robots, Quillbots, etc., I feel threatened. Yeah.
I'm worried about the future competition either. Because the price of the houses are surging, so I have to make more money.
Totally agree.
Why trying to buy the house in a house prices that is so high? Like Taiwan is. So you're going to live in Taiwan in the future?
Okay, I agree with you. Then in the future, you'll say, why would you still want to rent a house? Why don't you sleep just in the house?
That's different level.
But rented house will also be expensive in the future. Yes. Because the house pricing is increasing.
Are you concerned about the relationship between Taiwan and China?
What?
Are you concerned about the relationship between Taiwan and China?
I'm worried, to be honest, but I don't think they will be aware, actually. There are, you know, US are trying flexing their diplomatic muscles and those kind of things, so I don't think they're really going to happen. So
if we put ourselves in an unsecure mindset every day, then we will feel like very stressed and feel a lot of pressure. But I don't think we need to like think about it too much because if it will happen, then it will happen.
I think it's still quite far away from our daily lives, right?
Guys, is it unfair for her to say that since she didn't have to join the military?
Well, I don't know if she's like trying to say this, but
we could be nurses.
Yeah, I mean, when what really happens, who knows, like, if
what
only boy or men are going on the on the field. Maybe the president will call everybody on the field.
And she will flee.
Oh. We will do different things in the war, maybe.
Would you be willing to take part in a war?
If it really needed, if we really need to fight on the battlefield, yes. Because I'm a citizen from Taiwan, so to protect our country is my business.
To be honest, if I have the choice, then I don't want to serve in the military. Sadly, I don't have any choice, so I will serve in the military and fight for Taiwan.
Well, if I get to choose, to be super honest, no. Yeah, no.
Yeah.
Because, you know, I think it's a pretty, because I'm kind of guy who have a plan for like the next few years and the war just happens and like it's all screw up. I don't feel like I belong to this country maybe. Yeah, so I don't really willing to fight for this country.
Yeah, like when the war really, really happened and it's worse to the girls need to be on the battlefield. First, I will consider that if our government really protect us, and then I will go on the battlefield because we don't have any choice.
Taiwan is a place where I can freely pursue my dreams. Agreeers, please step forward.
For me, Taiwan is a place I can pursue my dream because my dream is to live happily with my people I love.
I think Taiwan is a place that I can freely pursue my dreams because the society is relatively open.
No disagreeers, please come forward.
I don't agree, because currently my dream is to study abroad, and so Taiwan cannot let me fulfill my dream. However, after I fulfill my dream, maybe Taiwan will be the next, will be the place where I can freely consume my dream, my next dream.
The reason why I don't think Taiwan is a place where I can freely pursue my dreams is because I feel like my passions and interests are not held at a really high regard here in Taiwan.
I want to be a environmental analysis. And if I go to a bigger city, maybe China, maybe United States, that means I will have more resources and more opportunity to pursue.
I don't think I can pursue my dreams here. The reason is rather simple and similar to Samuel's, because my dream is to move out of Taiwan and to immigrate, because I believe I've spent enough time here in Taiwan and I would really love to try out new things and new environment.
Can you specifically talk about what you want to be in the future, your dreams?
I would like to be a happy person.
For me, I am really insecure if I don't know where I'm going. But currently, my dream job is to become a doctor. But very contradictory is that I really want to move out of Taiwan. So I don't think my family can support me go to medicine school in other countries. So I would just have to choose between being a doctor or move out. So yeah, and so I say Taiwan is not the best place for me to pursue my dreams.
For me, my dream job is to be an engineer. Just like my parents, they are all engineers in Nanke. So yeah, I want to be part of them.
I'm also someone I'm someone who's very goal-oriented because I also feel very insecure if I don't have a single goal in mind. But what I want to be in the future is a literature professor, which I believe would give me a better chance of success if it's not in Taiwan.
Well, for me, I used to be being a data analyst, and now I'm into environmental science. I want to combine these two because I have interest in this both. And I know in Taiwan, this kind of career is not that popular and many people don't even heard of it. But if you go to the United States, there are a lot of opportunities.
That's a wrap. Thank you.
Yay. Yay.
Well, I see myself working in a tech company and living in an apartment with my partner.
I see myself working on my PhD with a loving partner by my side.
I see myself sipping gin and tonic on Malibu Beach as an environmental data analyst.
I see myself as a full-time mother.
I see myself working as a biochemist in Canada, trying to make the world a better place.
I see myself speaking on the stage of Tech Talk about how to live a good life without pursuing a dream.